Field in Philadelphia, PA.
Today, rivals square off in the NFC East, and we've got a great matchup
between the Washington Commanders and the Philadelphia Eagles. Joey Sly, the kicker, stands ready.
And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And he'll get this up just shy of the 30.
Here we go.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Another run here with Sanders. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Hurts. Airing it out deep for Smith. This is caught inside the 15. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line. And that looked almost to be a case of, you know, a quarterback saying, hey, I'm going to throw this as far as I can and hope you run under it. Mission accomplished. They'll run the jet sweep with Brown. And he is going to lose yardage here. Different story this time around. We had that huge gain followed by a sizable loss here.
You see that celebration from him after that stop? Those corners don't normally have the chance to get behind the line of scrimmage and hand them big losses. So when he got that opportunity, he certainly made it a memorable one.
It's complete to Brown, right side. And the Eagles are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical, they've been crisp, and as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early first and goal.
They'll run with Sanders. And no signal yet. I don't think he got in. He didn't. They'll mark him at the one. No gain on the play, and it's going to be second and goal.
They're right there at the one. No gain, but don't let that stop you. Line back up and keep going at them. If I'm them, I'm thinking about going at it four straight times.
Oh, the sneak. It's Hurts. And he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. Jalen Hurts scoring on the sneak from a yard out. And the Eagles will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon. Elliott good on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Wentz bringing the Commanders up for first and 10
at their own 19-yard line.
Throwing is Wentz. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. 2 yards on the pickup there, and that's going to bring up second down. Throwing now is Wentz.
knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
I haven't seen more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
That was their first 3rd down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key 3rd down throws.
They'll go for it. It's Wentz. This is caught by his tight end, Logan Thomas. And this is going to wind up working out just fine as he'll have a Washington 1st down. And an exhale there as they convert on 4th. Again, and that will be incomplete. They couldn't hook up on what's going to be the final play of this 1st quarter. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. So after the incompletion on 1st, now 2nd and 10. Play action. Now Wentz. Throw to the right here, taken in by McLaurin. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
First is Wentz. Thomas brings it in. And some room to run now. A huge play there for Washington. 47 yards for an offense that has not found the end zone yet. That's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
Gibson will score. Touchdown, Commanders. Well, they move the ball down the field through the air, Charles, and then finally they get the running game involved, and it works to perfection. Touchdown.
And, partner, I kept waiting for that running game to come into play and actually saved it until the very end. Touchdown goes on his stat sheet, but you and I both know, and he knows as well, his teammates airing it out made this a successful drive.
Extra point by Sly is up and good, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it, each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. At the line, this Philly offense set to go. A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partners, a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now, but let's give credit where it's due because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
And because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Now fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
On the set.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Throwing is Hurts. And this one incomplete, threw it down at the feet of his receiver.
The defender certainly didn't forget about him leaking out of the backfield. There was a guy ready and waiting to pick him up in coverage, and that throw had no shot.
They go play action with Hurts. On the move, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Montez Sweat, the man that time to fight in and drop him.
We've watched this a long time, and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long, why are you calling play action?
Yeah, because they're not going to bite defensively, right?
No, not at all. I did have a coach explain to me years ago that for some teams, that's how they have to deal with pass protection and their line blocking, but to me it seems silly.
Yeah, well, they're silly, and it leads to a play action sack.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. The last time out, they had to march almost the full length of the field for their touchdown. So here, much easier, Charles, with this better starting field position.
I love your sarcasm, but I love even more your observation because, look, what they did last time out, now with a shorter field, they should have a lot of confidence and put more points up on the board.
Now Wentz on third down. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes.
Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
And they weren't in zone coverage, they were in man, and each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a defensive player of the year at the other, and they just locked people down.
Wentz to throw for it on four. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position.
So they take a big, big chance here in their own territory. And you think the coach may have some questions to answer?
Yeah, and, you know, normally we focus on the media, right? The social media barrage that he's going to get for this one. How about on his own sideline and in his locker room? Because I think the team's going to look at him like, coach, well, why would we go for it there? I mean, no confidence in the defense. You don't like the punter. I mean, what's going on here? You owe us some explanations.
To throw again on second down. Hurts. And once again, this is Sanders. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Hurts a handoff to Sanders. And he'll get 7 yards from the 17 to the 10 before he's taken down. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the upmen. And they'll be set up with good field position here as he gets this up over the 40-yard line.
What's always interesting about situations like this is that in both locker rooms, both staffs were preaching a quick start. One of them actually got it done.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
Well, the first half, very even. I mean, really, in all facets, this ball game tied, Charles. So as we start the third quarter, curious to see what the second half brings us.
Certainly am. I'm with you on that one. And we all know a lot of coaches from the NFL all the way down to the peewee level. They love to spin it to their teams. Hey, we're starting a brand new shorter ball game. It's all even. Let's go out and seize it. This is ours.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. Here's Wentz to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick 6 TD.
Well, mistake there by the offense, Charles. They tried to pick on a Pro Bowl corner in coverage there, and not the smartest decision. He reminded him that he was a Pro Bowl corner with not only the pick, but the pick 6.
And those guys who have that designation, sometimes they get a little bit bored in games because people try to avoid them. They absolutely love it when they get challenged, and it's a chance to remind everyone exactly why they were tagged as one of the best in the league the prior season.
Elliott good with a PAT, and that makes the score 14-7. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Well, remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick 6, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick 6 and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
Wentz's throw taken in by Samuel.
And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds.
15 yards the pickup. 1st down, Washington.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you want to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
We couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, 1-score game, 1st and 10 here. A give up the middle to Gibson.
And a scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9.
Now a first carry here for Robinson.
And he'll push forward for a couple to the 34. 3rd down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points.
And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Wentz going to go on 4th down.
Throws the out route and completes it to Samuel. And this is going to wind up working out just fine as he'll have a Washington first down. And an exhale there as they convert on fourth. On first and 10, it's Robinson.
And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. So their task a little bit more difficult now. Second and 13 that they're walking up on. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. Now Wentz. Open man, that's Milne. And to the 49-yard line, but no further. And obviously, he is well short of the first. Here we go on fourth down with Wentz. That's to his running back, complete. And the tackle going to be made at the 38. Boy, that's some kind of effort. When he caught it, I doubted if he could get there. Knew it was going to be close, but credit him. Really good effort.
How about the rack on that play, the run after catch? But most of the time, we think of it as just being an open field and picking up yardage. Sometimes you have to be real physical in order to gain the yardage you need for a first down.
So the fourth down conversion has him inside the 40 now, first and 10.
To throw, it's Wentz. Middle of the field, he's got McLaurin. Down inside the 10. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. That one good for 37 yards.
We know play callers can be very creative in this game today, but sometimes when they've got receivers with speed like this, they don't need to design incredibly complex calls. Sometimes it's just get the ball in his hands and let him do his thing. In a sense, less can become more, and it was right there.
It's a sneak. It's Wentz. And he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. Carson Wentz scoring on the sneak from a yard out.
And the Commanders have a chance to tie the ball game here in the final minute of the third.
Nice job of polishing off that drive, but all the credit there goes to that play prior.
Yeah, it certainly does, because after that big play, I think resistance almost felt futile at that point, didn't it? And the very next play, they come right back, quick, fast, and in a hurry, and put it in the end zone.
Extra point by Sly is up and good, and we are tied at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Offense set to begin their next drive, and their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. A little jet sweep to start the drive, and he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, they gave up a few yards there, but all in all, I think it's a pretty nice job defensively against the Jets sweep. If they don't slow him up, he might take it to the house, so they'll take that play every time on the defensive side of the ball.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play, so we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
On the jump.
Second and 6, just inside the 30. Hey. They'll run with Sanders up the middle. 7 yards there and a first down.
Cowboy 80. 60 Eagles. 60 Eagles.
Buffalo 18. Drop 50. Drop 50.
Go. Here's Hurts to throw. And his pass incomplete.
Great coverage there all around. Really didn't have many options to throw the football.
Very little chance that that one was going to be completed. Every receiver was locked up.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10.
Hurts sets up to throw it.
Looking here for Smith downfield. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides. And there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
Hurts.
And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete. The defense did their job. Fourth quarter, big stand.
No doubt about it, because the offense has been yelling at him from the sideline. Just do us a favor. Get us the ball back. Give us one more chance to take it downfield. The defense just did them a solid, it appears.
And when they get the ball back, they can kind of play free, tie game. They're not behind. Sanders trucks over him. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he shortened the line to gain. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth. And that will force a turnover on downs.
On first and 10, it's Gibson.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9. On play action, wins. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. That sack courtesy of the effort of Hassan Reddick.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Wentz now to throw. Forced out to his left. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
Well, so much for the four-minute offense. They were trying to reduce the clock, get in position to win the game, and leave no time for them to come back and catch him. And guess what? They turned the ball over.
Yeah,
I mean, they had it all set up for themselves, and they let it get away.
But first down, Hurts.
And only able to get two here. Stopped at the 30.
Ready? Hawk 70.
Looking to throw again on second down. Hurts. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. A field goal from this spot would be 51 yards. They'll try to move it closer on third down.
60 Vikings. 10 for 11. 19 right.
19 right here. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And unable to connect, incomplete. I'll give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Ranger. 19 sight, 19 pace.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts.
It's caught by Sanders.
And he is going to have an Eagles first down. And that was something else. A big pickup on fourth and long to give him a new set of downs.
A big pickup there. 20 yards as they convert on fourth.
Let's go.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports.
Ready? Mustang 19. Go.
On first and 10, it's Hurts.
Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
On second and 10, Hurts, and he can't get a throw away. He's taken down.
So after that sack, Hurts and the Eagles, tough spot here, third and long.
Back to throw here.
And this one dropped in the end zone. Looked like a touchdown, but not to be, and now it's fourth down.
So a big, big kick coming now for Jake Elliott. This for the lead in the final stages. The kick by Elliott is good, and they have taken the lead here in the final 2 minutes.
So he waited on the sideline for his first chance in the ball game, and it didn't come until the fourth quarter, but he connects there. A big one to give him the lead.
Boy, you talk about coming in cold. I don't care how many times you kick it into a net. You're not really ready when you go out there and all that beef is coming at you trying to block the kick. Big spot, and he delivers.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away.
They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive, a little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punch in the end zone without turning it over.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Wentz to throw. And the comeback may stall out. It's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And the Eagles have just about sewn up this football game.
Well, you knew you had to take some chances here with the clock winding down, needing a touchdown to win it. And that one might have just sealed their fate.
Yeah, and that's the nature of the two-minute drill. The offense trying to go downfield and make their plays. But defenses, they're sitting back watching everything that they do, but not too far back. They want to be in position to make a play on the ball, and that they did.
And look at this. miss. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted.
Picked off by Benjamin St. Juiced. And the Commanders will take over here at their own 12-yard line.
Oh my, how the tables have turned now. They were trying to salt this one away, but that interception, potentially a game changer.
And I've just got to think to myself, at this point of the game, I know you've been aggressive. I know that's your MO, and that's fine. And all those teams that talk about all gas, no brakes, you better have the emergency lever to pull occasionally. They could have used it right there. They put themselves in a tough spot.
What a huge mistake late. It's intercepted. Picked off by Hassan Reddick.
And so much for the game-winning two-minute drive. I think that interception return there pretty much seals the deal.
And one thing to keep in mind, in this situation with the score that close, defense isn't backing off and just giving you easy throws. They're playing aggressively as well, and they end up picking that one off and sealing the deal for themselves.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
Set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again, but they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly, then they'll take it from there.
Had his hands on it, but dropped it. But a rookie making a little bit of a rookie mistake. Third down.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely four-down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the first down in two installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
To throw is Wentz. And that's incomplete.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
Now Wentz, gotta have this one. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. And the Eagles are gonna take possession.
I told my boys, it ain't no limit. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limit. Put your head in the game.